Hi, this is Avinash Sharma, and in this session, we will discuss how to refresh the Power BI reports using the scheduled refresh. So first of all, we check the architecture of publishing the report. So in the left side, you can see, suppose you are working a local machine, your own machine, and on that machine, you have your report and the database. It means the other users sitting on the remotely cannot access your report because your report and the database is not on the web. Now, when you publish, so what happens? Suppose you are using an Excel sheet. So after publishing the report and database, both are the transferred to the cloud-based system so that other users sitting remotely can access your report. That's why we publish the Power BI report. Now we check the second scenario of the publishing the report. Suppose your database is deployed on your on-premise server. So what is the premise server? It is a server owned by the company or office and it is deployed on the same building. Now, to connect up your on-premise server, you must have the credential. So for that purpose, you have to create the gateway connection. In the left side, you can see, suppose you are working in the local machine and local machine, you have the reports, but databases is coming from your on-premise server. So when you create the gateway connection, the admin of the server will provide the credential and you have to supply those credentials in the connection. After that, you can connect the on-premise server because this server is a secure server. Still, your report on your local machine and the remote users cannot access. Now, after in the right end, when you publish the service, in the right side, when you publish the report, so again, the report is deployed on the cloud-based system, but the database is still on your premise server. Connection is there. So other users can access the report and the data. Data is coming from your on-premise server. So when you refresh the reports, so actually, data is being refreshed on premise server. Now we'll check the third scenario. In case suppose we are using the Google Sheet and Google Sheet is already on your cloud-based system. So on local machine, your Power BI reports and still you can collect the Google Sheet, which is now on the cloud-based system. But still, the other users cannot access your report because your report is not published on your local machine. In that end, you can see, once you publish the report, so that your report is deployed on your cloud-based system and Google Sheet is already on your cloud-based system. So that connection automatically maintained in the publishing the report. So when you change the Google Sheet, there are two methods. You can refresh the reports manually. Otherwise, you can set the schedule, date and time, delivery weekly. This kind of schedule you can set for refreshing the report. So as we discussed, we would be using the cloud-based Google Sheet. So we have some list of the Google Sheet and we would be using this sales year-wise. If I check this one, so we have some data, year, quarter one, quarter two and quarter three. In year, we have the different type of years. Then quarter, we have the sales for quarter one, quarter two and quarter three. And to connect this Google Sheet, we would be using this URL. Now, after connecting this Google Sheet to the Power BI report, and when we publish this one, so how to refresh? When we add some data or delete data or update data in this Google Sheet, so we'll check how to refresh those data in our Power BI report. Now, we check how to connect the Google Sheet. So, get data, more, then search Google Sheet, Google, connect. Now, Google Sheet URL, go to your Google Sheet and copy the URL. and paste. Now, okay. So we have the data, load. Now we check the data. So we have the year, quarter 1, 2 and 3. Now, we create a visual table. Then one, two, and three, and no summarize. So we have the data from the Google Sheet. Now, suppose we publish the report, and then we change the Google Sheet. Then how to refresh the data? So first of all, we publish this report, and the name of this report is the year-wise sales data. Publish. Now, so we have the different type of workspace, and I select this one, mic workspace. Select and wait for few seconds. So report is published. Now click on this one. So you can observe the report has been published. Now Google Sheet, we add the one more entry, that is the 2024 and sales data for quarter 1, quarter 2 and the quarter 3. Okay, we go to the report and workspace, we select the data. Data set. In data set, we have the three dots. Click on that one. Now, we have the two methods. Refresh now and the schedule refresh. So, first of all, refresh now. So, this is done now. Now, we have to refresh the visuals. Now, you can see 2024, this data has been refreshed. This means added on the report. This is the first method. Second one, on the data set, it says scheduled refresh. Now, in case of the scheduled refresh, we have some option, gateway connection. If you check this one, then you don't need a gateway for this data set, because the data set is already on our cloud, that is the Google Sheet. So we don't need any the gateway connection. If we use the on-premise server, then we have to create the gateway connection. And scheduled refresh, so by default it's off, and we make it on. Then there are two types, refresh frequency, weekly or daily. Suppose say I select weekly, then this is the Sunday, Monday, Tuesday. On which day you want to refresh the data? You can select all days, or you can select the few days, not the all days. Suppose if I change say daily. So in case of the daily, we have to add the times, say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and that's it. It means we can refresh the reports 8 times in a day. This is the limit. Why? Because if you refresh the reports say every hour or every minute, then that will put the too much pressure on the server. So that's why, so to avoid this situation, the Power BI has imposed the limits. You can refresh the reports 8 times in a day. So you can mention the time here, say AM, PM or etc. And this is the time zone. Every country has its own time zone. So according to that, like time zone or country, you can select here the time zone. Now, we have sent refresh failure notification too. So in case of you check this one, then you get the notification by the email. So this is how you can refresh the reports by scheduling it. So guys, this was all about the how to refresh the reports by scheduler. For more update, please subscribe the channel and like this video. Thanks for watching the video.